Okay, starting next year, Huawei is dropping Android in place of their own in-house Harmony OS. It's official, this is happening. And on one hand, I think this is brilliant news. I love the idea of going into a store to pick a smartphone and actually having three operating systems to choose from: iOS, Android, and Harmony OS. Besides, I love Huawei phones. For the last 3 years, Huawei is probably the only company whose launch events I've been consistently excited for. I've almost got used to the fact that when Huawei launches a new flagship phone, it's going to be world's first at something, and it's going to be world's best at some other things. So this is also good news in that it means Huawei phones aren't disappearing anytime soon. These past 2 years have been just brutal for the company. They were banned from selling phones in the US, then they lost access to Google, then they lost their 5G infrastructure in a lot of places around the world. And while all this is happening, one by one, Huawei's collaborators have slowly but surely pulled away. And I'm just sitting here gawping at the fact that they are still standing and fighting back. Like, literally 3 days after the UK government announced that Huawei will be ripped out of our 5G infrastructure, Huawei announces that they're about to drop £10 million building three flagship experience stores in the UK. This company is nothing if not persistent. But you probably saw this coming. Harmony OS has some big problems in trying to go up against iOS and Android. And if you're enjoying this video, by the way, a sub to the channel would be super. Harmony has benefits, don't get me wrong. Being built from the ground up to work on Huawei devices means it'll probably be hyper-efficient. In the same way that on games consoles, which have fairly underpowered hardware, developers can still create beautiful software because it's built with that exact hardware in mind. Huawei actually said back in 2019 that Harmony OS is so simple and efficient that one line of code in Harmony can do the work of 100 lines of code in Android. That is a vast claim. And although it doesn't really mean much without context, I wouldn't be surprised if Harmony OS devices can run faster while consuming less battery. And they will be able to run Android apps. I double-checked this just before making this video, so that means Huawei won't have to start from scratch with its app library, which is what a lot of people were worried about. Plus, the final and main benefit is that Harmony is a distributed operating system, which means it can basically run on anything. Everything from your watch to your toothbrush. There's a real TV that you can buy that runs Harmony OS, and they're locking in deals now to try and build it into major brand appliances, as well as apparently 5 million cars by next year. The idea being that all of these devices running the same operating system can communicate each other without you needing to do anything. They'd have this kind of shared intelligence. For example, let's say I'm playing music from my phone to one set of speakers in one room. If I then walk to another room, my speakers will be able to communicate with my phone and know that I've changed room, so they'll know to change the audio output from that room to that room. Or you could have a video call with someone, and you'd be able to use the front cameras and the microphones from your phone so that they could see and hear you, but you would be able to see and hear them on your big screen TV with your surround sound cinema quality speakers, if you wanted to. This kind of shared multi-device experience. However, I just don't think that this move to Harmony OS phones is quite the power move that it initially seems. Like, when you read the headline that Huawei is moving to their own operating system, it kind of feels like the company is finally playing their ace card. Like, they planned all of this and it's now just coming together. In actuality, I just think it's more of a consequence of the dire situation that they've been put in, a response to the fact that they've been cut from so many of the companies that they want to work with. It's just so they have more control over their own fate. And while I really, really do want them to succeed on this, I think it's going to be tricky. For starters, and this is just a prediction, but I think Harmony is going to look and feel very similar to the company's existing software. Yes, Harmony OS is very different to Android, as a core for phones to run on, but if I had to guess, I think what Huawei's gonna do is to try and make it look as much like their existing Android phones as possible. Think about it, Huawei has spent years improving and tweaking their MUI software skin, making it how they think is perfect. MUI is well known, it's feature-packed, it is trusted by a lot of people. So even though Huawei will move away from Android as a base, it probably doesn't make a lot of sense for them to change the software skin that runs on top of it, the way it looks and feels to customers. So when you look at it that way, you start to realize that in a best case scenario, to use, Harmony OS phones probably won't feel entirely new. Potentially more efficient, potentially better integrated with other devices, but fundamentally just smartphones that can run Android apps and that can't run Google apps. Besides, arguably the biggest benefit of Harmony OS is how it works with these other devices. But In order to get that benefit, you've got to buy not just a Huawei phone, but a Huawei speaker, a Huawei computer, a Huawei-powered car. It's just a huge ask. And the reason why I think it'll be tricky for Huawei is that, at least from what we've seen, remember this is not confirmed fact, but I don't think Harmony OS will solve the problem Huawei is having. Huawei isn't struggling because of a lack of inter-device connectivity. Rightly or wrongly, it's a trust problem. There seems to be a growing number of people unwilling to even purchase from their store because they don't want to share their credit card details with them. Could you imagine what it's going to take to change that sentiment to, oh, actually, yeah, let's buy a Huawei phone. And in fact, let's let Huawei control our entire home. Huawei is already having a trust problem, even when its phones are based on Android. This, if anything, is only going to be worse with their own operating system. For this to be successful, at least in the US and Europe, Huawei have to change the entire perception of their company. And it's just not an easy task. They probably don't even have a price advantage. You know, after the US ban first came, I was half expecting Huawei phones to become more affordable to compensate, but it doesn't look like that happened at all. Huawei has always been a premium brand, and if they're going to stay that way, I just don't know what their angle is. People in the West are very happy and very used to Google services. And sure, had this US ban not happened, I might well be using a Huawei phone now, because they do have brilliant cameras and brilliant battery life. But I wouldn't say their hardware is so far ahead that I'd be willing to give up on core parts of the user experience I want. I recently made a video talking about how a couple of times Samsung has already tried to fight Google with their own operating system, and how it just didn't work. This feels like a very similar situation, only that the odds are stacked against Huawei far more than they ever were against Samsung. Google Android is now even more ingrained in our lives, and Huawei has not just a fading reputation to deal with, but also the fact that they've lost a lot of the companies they've been working with over the years, which means that now they've got to build new relationships from scratch, which A, probably means higher component costs, and B, a product that's just less good. This US ban is not as simple as just avoiding a few specific US companies. The US are everywhere. Like, Huawei has even been blocked from working with firms just because they use US technologies and US equipment. Huawei can't do business with Taiwanese TSMC, who used to build their chipsets. There's a recent report which says they won't even be able to get their displays and their RAM from Samsung anymore, because apparently the display controller chip has had some US involvement. There is a very small chance that Qualcomm could be granted access to supply chips to Huawei, but I feel like that would be like a really small light in a really dark cave. Good news, but I just don't think it will change much. Okay, you get the idea. Huawei has a lot more work to do versus its competition to deliver a product that outside of China, I'm not even sure people need. I hope it works, and I can't wait to see it and to try it, but until I do, I'm positively skeptical. If you enjoyed this video, do consider subscribing. It would really mean a lot to me. Thanks a lot for watching. My name is Aaron. This is Mr. Who's the Boss, and I'll catch you in the next one.